Today I wanted to do a continuation video of our smelting series, and today we're going to be looking at how to remove the copper from your copper button that we poured in the previous video, and I'll post a link to that here on the video so you can check that one out. But on the last video we smelted some black sand using copper as a collector metal, and I want to show you now how I'm going to remove the copper and get the gold and the silver out. This is about 7 or 8 of those little copper pyramids that we made in the previous video. I melted them all down in the same kiln we used for the smelting, and I poured them into a 4-inch piece of channel so I could increase their surface area. I want a lot of surface area so the electroplating solution can get to the copper. I'm going to use this DC power source here and mix up a solution of copper sulfate and sulfuric acid. And I have those two pieces of stainless steel in there that are going to be connected to the cathode, or the negative terminal. And I'm going to hang the copper piece right down between the two pieces of stainless there. And that'll be the anode. So the copper is going to plate from the copper piece that's going to hang right here onto the stainless steel cathodes, and the gold and silver will not go into solution, and they'll fall out as the anode slimes into the bottom of our bucket. So here is the recipe I'm going to be using: about 30 ounces per gallon of copper sulfate, about 8 ounces a gallon of sulfuric acid, and volts between 1 and 3. So here's a gallon of water. This is what I'm going to be using for my copper sulfate. It's a septic tank root killer, but the active ingredient is 99% copper sulfate pentahydrate, which is just a hydrated form of copper sulfate. And here is my sulfuric acid. Both of these I got at the hardware store. This is for drain opener. Here's what the copper sulfate crystals look like. So they're just going to go right in the water, and I'm going to just dump a whole bunch of it in there. I'm going to stir that around until all that dissolves, and if it all dissolves, I'm going to pour more in, and if it doesn't all dissolve, I'm going to decant the solution back into the 5-gallon bucket there so we don't have any standing crystals sitting on the bottom. And then I'll add my sulfuric acid and we'll start plating. Now I'm going to take my copper bar here and I'm going to break it in probably 3 pieces. That weighs about 3.5 pounds, so I'm going to break it into smaller manageable pieces and we'll plate each one at a time. And there's my copper piece we're going to plate out. I got a good strong clamp on there and it's just holding it. And you want to make sure your clamp doesn't enter the solution or it'll plate out as well. So I'll switch on the power. We're running about 0.5 volt and about 9 amps. Here we're going to check on our plating process here. It's been just about 24 hours since we put it in. Oh yeah, and our coppers, you can see it's all covered in black anode slimes there. So I'm going to try and just give her a little dunk. Get the camera in the right spot here. You can see all the black anode slime stuff washed off. You can see the copper coming through. Here's a look at our cathode. Lots of nice copper getting plated on it there. Good copper going there. So I pulled out one of the stainless steel cathodes and I just gave it a little bend and bent the stainless. And you can see the hole. The whole copper sheet comes right off and you get a clean cathode, you can start over. And the copper from our 24-hour plating experiment, we got 109 grams. So that's how much copper was plated out in 24 hours. And it'll all depend on the voltage, the current, the surface area, the anode and stuff. But that just gives you kind of an idea of in the ballpark of what we can plate in a 24-hour period. All right, it's been 9 days since we started, and we have finished plating out all three pieces of that bar. You can see here's a whole bunch of copper and stuff that we plated off the cathodes, peeled off the cathodes. Here's some other copper that it got a little spongy there towards the end. You can see it's not a nice solid plate, it's just kind of crumbly. And the great part about this is now we can take all the copper here that we have a whole lot of surface area with, and even some of the spongy copper that we can break up into essentially copper powder and use it for the smelting process, so we can just keep recycling the copper over and over again. This is a little piece of one of our anodes, and what I did is as it sat in the solution plating, there was a piece across the top that was out of the solution, so it stayed, it didn't plate out. So when they got to about 10% of the remaining copper in the solution, I turned it over so that big thick plate was then in the solution, and I could clamp it up here at the top where it was real thin. So I'm left with, about 20 grams of copper there. And I can just put this back in with that stuff and use it as a collector metal and recycle that. So nothing is lost, and we'll use it all over again. So this is our solution we used for the plating. It's gotten quite dark due to impurities that came off the copper anode. And there's a bunch of black sludge in the bottom of that stuff that's the anode slimes. And that's where all of our precious metals are going to be. So I'm going to filter the anode slimes out using a couple coffee filters and a funnel. And after that's done, we can then smelt down the anode slimes and get our precious metals out. So here's our funnel. I've put a couple pieces of copper wire down through there to act as ribs, so the solution can drain through the filter a little faster. I'm just going to use some coffee filters in there. And now we can pour the solution through the coffee filters. I found the best way to do this is to just decant the stuff off the top using a little smaller jug. And that way you can keep all the sediment in the bottom until the end so it doesn't clog your filter up. So I just pour my solution into the filter, let it drain through, and repeat until all of the solution has been used up. Okay, we're getting down to the bottom of our solution here. And you can see I switched over to a shop towel there, so it'll go a little faster. It's a little bit coarser filter, but we'll get the majority of the large stuff out, and then if we want to fine filter with coffee filters later, we can do that. Here's the bottom of the solution. You can see all the black sludge down there. I'll reach down here and get a little bit for you. And I don't know if you can see in the video, but there's some copper left that flakes off the cathodes as you're plating. So what I'm going to do, so I have a piece of probably about 30 mesh stainless steel screen that I'm going to pour the anode slimes through so it'll catch any of those big pieces of copper, so we're not fighting copper when we smelt down the anode slimes, because that's just counterproductive. Okay, it's been a couple hours and our stuff's drained through our filter here. And you can see all the black sludge that's left over all clinging to the filter paper there. And so what I'm going to do over the next couple days is get this dried out pretty good, peel it off the filter paper that we used, and I'll make another video here when I get a chance. We're going to smelt this down with some oxidizing flux and get our precious metals out. So thanks for watching this segment of our smelting and refining series. I will be posting another video when I have a chance of the smelting of our anode slimes here, and I will post a link to that at the end of this video when it's available. And I appreciate you guys watching, and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks.